Hi, welcome to SolidWorks 2017 video tutorial. I want to do that 7-cylinder radial engine now in SolidWorks. So let's have fun with SolidWorks. Okay, so let's start with a new and empty assembly, and I want to insert my first part, which would be the housing. Where is it? There it is. Open it and place it, and it will be fixed at the origin. Now I need 3 sub-assemblies. So insert component, new assembly. This will be seems. It's not possible to rename it. Really? Now it's able. This will be the sub ASM piston and rod and bolt. Then another new one. This will be the sub assembly piston and main rod and bolt. And another one, which will be the cylinder sub-assembly cylinder. I will start with this one. So edit assembly, not customized, but edit assembly. Okay, and I could hide that one, or doesn't matter. Insert component, and I need the cylinder. Open, put it somewhere. Next, insert the foot. And then insert the head. Okay, let's rotate that component, maybe like this. Okay, and now align this axis and that axis concentric. Then this face coincident to that face. This to that concentric. And maybe I first put in the screws. So go to insert component, the long one, open, put it right there. Okay, now maybe first the face, this face to that face coincident. And I want to flip the orientation. So flip make alignment. That's more like it. Where is my screw? There it is. And then this axis to that axis right here. Concentric. Now I want to do a new pattern. these parts are not done with SolidWorks, so I cannot reuse a pattern. And anyway, it would only work with fixed or rigid subassemblies. So go for a circular component pattern. Use that axis. I want to have, use that axis right here. I want to have four with equal spacing, and I want to pattern this one. Confirm. Now align that axis to this one, concentric, and face coincident to that face. Now this can be turned, so I want to align the planes. That's the foot and the cylinder, and choose maybe the front plane, yes, and the cylinder, and the front plane in the foot, and make it coincident. Close these. I need another screw, the short one. Okay. Place it maybe here and align that face with this face, coincident, flip mate alignment, and then axis to axis, concentric. Another pattern, circular, around this axis, four instances, equal spacing, and I want to pattern this component. And confirm. Now leave that subassembly and put it here. So this one and that one should be concentric. This one and that one concentric, so that is aligned correctly, and this face to that face coincident. Very nice. Now I can do another pattern. Another circular one. The axis would be this one. I need seven instances. Make sure you always let the program calculate the angle and don't type in the angle. And I want to pattern that subassembly cylinder, this one, and confirm. Very nice. I should hide the components and this one as well. Okay. Now my next subassembly will be the piston and rod. This one. So edit this one. And insert the piston then insert the rod and insert the bolt. That's this one. Okay, Now let's align this axis to that axis, concentric. Then this face and that face right here to this face and that face, and you will get that width constraint, sort of a centering constraint. Nice. Now this axis to that one, concentric, and again the width. I could use this so go for that face and that face and use the axis of this one, and it seems I lost the other side, so select once again this face and that face to that axis. There it is. Okay, now move this possibly to the other side. Should be possible. That's strange. I'm in the subassembly. This is fixed. That's not fixed. That's not fixed. Maybe I let's rotate that component here. Yeah, it's sort of, yeah. Of course, let's suppress that last constraint for the moment. Not this one, but that one. And now I should be able to move it around. Yeah, it's sort of an extreme position. And then unsuppress it. Now it should work. Yeah. Leave that subassembly. And rebuild and make, should be somewhere, yeah, there it is. Move it maybe to this side. Yeah, I need 6 copies altogether, so I need 5 copies of this one. So let's take that sub-assembly, this one, rebuild, and one, two, three, four, five. Now align those, concentric. 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 Well, let's see if it has to be flipped around. It has to be flipped around, so go to the latest. This one, flip mate alignment, and in this case maybe I should turn that component somehow like this, and align these concentric. Now let's move those a little bit away. So they're apart a little bit. Okay. Now I need my third subassembly. Let's rebuild. And that would be this one. I should check the name. It should be called not Eastern but Piston, and that A should be a small letter. Now let's edit this one. Insert, as before, the bolt, the rod and the piston. So I'll go for the piston first. I thought I'd go for the piston first. So that's the rod. Now the piston. Where is the piston? There's the piston. And the bolt. The bolt is there. Okay. Now this axis to, sorry, that's the wrong one. I need the main rod. So this should be deleted. And I need the main rod. And that will be this one. There it is. Okay. Now this one to that one, concentric. Then this face. That face, and of course this face and that face right here, so you get that centering constraint. Nice. Then this axis to that axis, concentric. And now this face, that face to that axis, centered, and that one, and go. This didn't work, so I lost something on the way. Okay, let's try once again. This face and that face should be centered to that axis. There it is, and centered. Now let's try to turn this one. Go for move component, rotate this one. Yeah. That's again in this position, it's sort of fixed. It's not fixed, but it behaves as fixed. So suppress. The last one, this one. Now I should be able to turn it. Not really. That's crazy. Yeah, because this one is fixed. Oh. None is fixed, so let's fix the piston. And now I should. Yes. That's really strange. Now I'm able to move it and leave that one. Now let's rotate that component like this and add a constraint. This axis to that axis, concentric. Okay. Now I want to hide this one. And if you want to insert those into that main rod, you have to make them flexible. Right now they're rigid and they should be flexible, all of these sub-assemblies. So usually this is in the mini ribbon up there. It used to be there. It's somehow not there anymore. So I customized my ribbon right here, assembly, and put that command up into my ribbon. Now let's take a look. This should be flexible. And these as well. Let's take a look. It's not possible to do them all at once, so I do them one by one. Next one, in version 16, this command was in the mini ribbon and only in the mini ribbon, not in the context menu. It's still not there, so I had to customize that multi ribbon. Now they're flexible, and now I could 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yes, insert those into the main rod. So let's go this axis to that axis, concentric. Then this axis to that axis, concentric. Sometimes the preview doesn't look right. See, it works. Now this one to that one, concentric. Don't get irritated. This one to that one, concentric. And if you do rebuild, it should be correct. If not, that's really crazy. Okay, this one to that one, concentric. Really, really strange. And the last one would be this one to that one, and again concentric. This looks interesting, and it doesn't show. This should be no. let's show this one. And maybe, just maybe. See, if it really doesn't update, that's really, really awkward and strange. So just try to move one of these and it will spring into place. Jump into place, sorry. Okay, what is missing? Again, the bolts in the middle. I will do not those. And the, what is called the crankshaft. Yeah. So go for another insert component. The crankshaft right here. Open. Seems this version is a little bit buggy. It's 17. Maybe it needs a service pack. So this face right here, this one to that one, concentric, and let's not concentric, coincident, and flip mate alignment, and then this axis to that one, concentric, and finally this one to that one, again concentric. Should work. Yes, it does. Now let's show our cylinders. There you go. Show it. And show these components as well. And then you could switch transparency. So it's easier to see. This one as well. Now if you move that crankshaft, your engine will run. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe and like my Facebook cat fan page. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.